sense of the priority. A number of approaches here. One was to look at the symbols on the ang bao, the four faces. What do they mean? The crown on the top of the four faces. Do they have any special meaning? So that sort of iconographic analysis was what preoccupied a number of the French scholars, notably for Mauss. Others, like Georges, looked at the epigraphic, and it was Mauss's credit in 1928. He clearly established that epigraph is clearly found in what Fayon is to be associated, at least from the time of Fayon, and dates it to Chia Waterman in 1927. Until then, the two had to be separated. So, the epigraphic study. Then the third one would be the architectural and archaeological investigations of the building history. And again, a later series of French art historians, archaeologists, notably Jacques de Marsay, who joined in 1967. Firstly, the experience of working on Corée du Nord, has written massive studies, very detailed studies on the architectural history of Fayon. And the archaeology of it, I think we are now at that phase. And John can say more about what is the current state of the archaeological investigations at the Fayon. And finally, what we will get is a few minutes here, the issue of style Angkor to dating. Let me hear in a word about style in art history. It's a very complex, controversial, and contested term when you say style in art history, but the most basic understanding is that it simply is a recognizable pattern of form that we use to group works of art, a series of paintings by an artist or two or three artists here. So, one last example I put here is the moment we see these two paintings, immediately this is a cubist style castle in Rangkei. And it comes the character itself comes from a chance remark by everyone eats. The middle view from Rangkei. And so that finds a style of art. And in our local art history, we also know that way we find the Nanyang art style and so on. So, style is a way of distinguishing groups of artists and their place in history according to the characteristics of their work that you can see. So what is the style of the Fayon? Where do you place it? Because if we assume that Angkor Wat is stylistically the accumulation, the classical apex of Angkor art architecture, then what about Fayon, but other monuments? Here you have a picture of this near view of Angkor Wat, very symmetrical and classical. But when it comes to the Fayon, Rangkei, Tapong, Mantikadai, Mantisheman, quite clearly these are part of one group of monuments, characteristics within one group. But can I take those monuments come before Angkor Wat or after Angkor, where according to the early French archaeologists and conservators of Angkor, they were seen as mediocre and degenerate forms of Angkor Wat is being caused here. And when we use these forms, degenerate, mediocre, we are comparing it to very much European art history terminology, going back to Henry Wulff, German art historian, was very much concerned with this idea of spirituality, the spirit of art history, and right art history, see in the vision, in the patterns. And Wulff was less interested in the issue of how biographies of artists can help us to understand that work. For him, if you look at it, you get an idea of what it's all about. And Wulff was also not into that kind of dramatic school. Other political needs, and possibly force. early form, classic form, tangling, and then we go to really degenerate form, wrong style of art. So, are we talking here of Angkor or the Bayon, early, and then Angkor Wat here, or are we putting the Bayon here, wrong? How do we decide where do we put the Bayon? It was another French art historian, Philippe Stern, who in 1957 came up with a date. He proposed that you look at modernization, therefore the little things which you come to, well, you can put the Bayon as a late 11th century monument associated with King Wallman. So, Stern argued that it is not only 19th century monument, very much later. Even Stern didn't quite get it right in 1927. This is the little book that we get to spawn a little bit here. And we subsequently did come back to this issue and acknowledge that Sergei has got it right in associating Bayon with Jawa 7 as a 13th century, not 11th century monument here. How this turns dual. Third way of doing the painting has become known as the method in art history. Method was simply based on very meticulous study analysis of change in shape and forms of motive ornamentation. And if you get a sufficient number of these same motives and arrange them, you can get a sequence from biology, put all the genre of that series of plants or birds. You can trace a family and then trace that evolution. And so this is from a book Stern did with his colleague on Indian art, of the principle to the same of the evolution of the mantra, which is a multi-animal form that includes crocodiles and elephants. And you can see here how Stern has traced its evolution. Yeah. The elephant is from there, it becomes a fish body, and then becomes a crocodile, and then evolves finally in a way. So, third point is that if you can get a series of these motifs, arrange them, and then you can get a date. So, Stern here was going the other way from people like Paul Wu, who almost spent his time searching for the meaning of the body. What is the meaning of four faces? Stern says, I'm one for that. And we're looking at the art forms, the decor, the motifs, the symbols, whether they can be put into a sequence and related to Indian art, and you trace the source and the date from that. And third, ideas in this respect have a very solid basis in European art history. It can be traced back to the art, to the French, to the Italian art historian, Giovanni Morelli, who, and this is an idea, argued that you can examine the details, the microscopic details of the artist's work, the way it is here, the way it is. And hands are the most difficult part, and any artist will paint. And so, the way an artist paints his fingers, his hands, immediately typifies that artist. So, Morelli was able to show that this painting by Titus, Irving, with a head of John the Baptist, is to be credited to Titus and not another artist, as was the prevailing identification until. I think of argument of years, and only Titan paints the years in that fashion. And in French art history, there is a very long tradition of connoisseurship, of taking the works of an artist, arranging it in a sequence, authenticating it, defining the style. This is an early style of the artist when he was young, there's the middle style, and there's the late style. And identify where you got your ideas from, sources of inspiration, and voila, you've got a catalog of resonating of higher forms of consciousness. That is still very much the artistry paradigm today, where if you're an artist, you reach a certain stature, then yes, you hope that some